Huxley is also famous because he is considered the father of the term agnostic. Now, the word agnostic is usually used differently from atheist. An atheist is somebody who believes that God does not exist. An agnostic is not really sure or argues that essentially there's not enough evidence to know if God exists or does not exist. But that's not how Huxley actually meant it. Huxley meant the term agnostic as somebody who was actually against, from the get-go, any concept of special knowledge or revelation. In other words, the Bible is completely invalid in the beginning because it claims to be from a divine source. We're not going to consider it. That was Huxley's contribution. So science and religion were indeed in conflict, and they were entirely irreconcilable. Huxley, of course, would propound his ideas. He would say things like this. He said, "Definitely and precisely marked is the structure of each animal, that in the present state of our knowledge, there is not the least evidence to prove that a form in the slightest degree transitional between any of the two groups," and he mentioned several, such as vertebrata or annulosa or mollusca or colenterata. He says, "There's nothing to suggest that there either exists or has existed during that period of the Earth's history which is recorded by geologists." In other words, he acknowledges there's really no great transitional forms that actually show how one major subkingdom of animals actually evolved into another. But he goes on, "Nevertheless, you must not for a moment suppose, because no transitional forms are known, that the members of the subkingdoms are disconnected from or independent of one another. On the contrary, in their earliest condition, they are all similar. And the primordial germs of a man, a dog, a bird, a fish, a beetle, a snail, and a polyp are in no essential structural respects distinguishable." In other words, ignore the geological evidence is what he basically says, and take a look at how embryos all look alike. Now, we'll unpack this idea later and see that a lot of the evidence of embryos looking alike was based upon faked and fudged documents. But that's another story we'll talk about later.